This is Openly Hostile Opinions with your host, Casey and Jay.
What the hell is wrong with you?
I can do anything I want to, people, at any time I want to.
No, we're looking for evil guys.
Bigot, rape, and discrimination. The crime which are weakening America's ideas.
Hey, let's get this party started.
Mom?
Hello, everyone. Welcome to this week's episode of the Openly Hostile Opinions. I am Casey, and I am here with my friend Jay, a.k.a. No Beard.
Yes, I shaved.
You look very professional today.
Very professional. I thought I looked like a 12-year-old.
Yeah. Well, I'm like the opposite. I got like a fucking neck beard going here. I've been playing too much WoW lately.
Yeah, the funny part, though, is in a week, I'll have my beard back. That took you about 3 months to grow.
I know. I can't grow. I'm 32 fucking years old, and I can't grow facial hair for some reason. I have no idea why. I've been like that my whole life, but yeah.
You think with the way it's kind of receding upwards that it might, you know, start migrating down?
I know. I'm getting this receding hairline, and it's like you think some of it would come down in my neck or whatever like that, but I guess not. Holy fuck, man. I got peach fuzz my whole life. I have no idea. The rest of all my body fucking hair grows everywhere, but not my face for some reason.
Would you say you have ample butt hair?
Yeah. Actually, I have a very fucking clean butt. there's hardly any hair on
you
it.
You heard actually. It here first, folks. Casey has a very clean butt.
Yeah, I do. There's hardly any hair on it. Not like my friend. He always says, yeah, I have such a hairy ass. My wife has to put Velcro gloves on when we have sex. To hold on.
Wasn't me. Don't look at me.
Yeah, I know. So what's today's beer, Jay?
Today's... This is another one of my favorites from Trogs Brewing Company. Mm-hmm. It is Perpetual IPA.
Yeah, we got the label here for you if people want to look at it. And it's not on the screen for some reason. It's a little mis... God, we just suck at camera.
Yeah, we're not good at the whole video thing.
We fucking suck. We finally get a camera. We can't even do that. There we go. It's Perpetual IPA. It's 7.5%. Yeah, where's Trogs from? Isn't that from Harrisburg?
Yeah, Trogs definitely a Pennsylvania thing.
It's from Harrisburg. I don't know. I've never had a bad beer for them. One of my favorites from them is the Hopback.
Oh yeah, Hopback's delicious.
Oh yeah, I've always see people drink this like all the time. So I'm like actually really excited to drink it, and I like IPA. So wait, it is an IPA, right?
Yeah, it's an IPA.
Okay, cheers, mate.
Cheers. It's definitely not your most balanced IPA by any stretch, but it's very good. It's got that kind of like malty sweetness at the first taste of it,
mm-hmm.
and then by the end of it, you get that bitter and a little bit of that alcohol burn.
Yeah,
it's good stuff.
Yeah, I don't know if I'm getting just so used to IPAs that it's not that hoppy to me. To tell you the truth,
it's hoppy, but it's not.
Yeah, it's not like overly crazy hoppy.
No, I mean it's definitely not. It's not like something that's just there to design to punch you in the tongue. But it's a strong beer.
Yeah, it is a strong beer. 7.5. You know. It says, oh no, that's the color. I thought I saw the word strawberry or something like that. I'm like, I don't taste any strawberries.
No, it just says
it's a straw golden color. It's not as strong as most IPAs. Like I said, I wouldn't. It's very delicious though. It's one of those. I'd say after dinner beers.
Yeah, I mean it's stronger than your like a wheat beer, but it's not gonna be one of those IPAs that suck all the moisture out of your mouth.
Yeah, like what was that one shit called? Oh wait, I
think Smash Bomb.
Oh my god, that shit was
fucking sucked all the taste out of your mouth for the next hour.
Yeah, I think this is really delicious. I'd fucking drink it again. I like this is a fireplace beer for me. Actually,
fireplace beer.
Yeah, like hot dogs and wieners type beer. I just think it's that smooth.
Good
and,
stuff.
If I would rate it, I would give it 4 Meryl Streep being a cunt out of 5. I was talking to Jay about that bitch pisses me off. I fucking hate that cunt.
It's not even the Donald Trump thing that's got him going.
I know, because like I don't care. Like everyone knows out there, I talk about it all the time. I hate politics, whatever. It's not that that's what she was talking about. It's when she started talking about how everyone in Hollywood she's up there wearing millions of dollars worth of jewelry. She's like, us Hollywood people are just like normal people. And then she goes and makes fun of everyone with, and says that we don't appreciate art anymore and we just watch MMA and football. I'm just like,
I'll have you know, Meryl, I appreciate art and watch MMA and football.
I've always hated her. She's like a feminist cunt. And I just fucking can't stand her. And like, it was funny because she got out there and she got all teary-eyed. I'm like, oh. I'm like, I didn't know we were going to get a performance today. Thank you.
And I don't mind Meryl Streep so much. The one I can't stand is fucking Barbara Streisand.
Oh, really?
Just her voice irritates me. Just looking at her.
I can't believe she sings, though. Like, when I found out she was singing, I was like, what fucking Jewish dick did she suck to get a fucking singing career? Oh, man.
Everybody has a singing career now with an Advent autotune. You can make anybody sound good. Look at all the Disney stars.
I know. I hear newer rap music, and all it sounds is like, it sounds like some kind of like far away foreign music or something.
It was cool when T-Pain did it. Now y'all need to stop.
that's the thing. Like, T-Pain did it, and it's just time to move on, people. Time to fucking move on.
Yeah, Cher did it first.
Yeah, that's true. Do you believe? That song's catchy as fuck, though.
They tried.
I don't care.
The producers of that song tried to keep that shit under wraps forever. Did that? They said it was some sort of envelope filter or something.
Really?
They wanted to keep it secret so they would be the only
ones.
Why
would they
want to
keep it secret? Oh, just because, yeah. Yeah. Well, it's always happened. Like 80s music. Try to find an 80s song without reverb on the voice. Like, it's almost impossible, I think. Except like Pantera or something. But he has natural filter. He just, you know, smokes non-filter cigarettes.
Yeah. Non-filter cigarettes, way too much pot.
Yeah. Yeah, I remember you were listening to something a while ago. And isn't he in a new band now or something?
He's got
singing from Pantera.
Dude, he's got like 10 of them.
Yeah, you were playing something. He sounds like...
That was a solo album.
Oh, okay.
Walk Through Exits Only.
What is with him and walking? The song walk
I don't
through
know.
Exits
it's the
only.
It's tough guy thing. Walk.
What does that mean? Walk through exits only.
He means I don't listen to shit, is what he's saying. I do things the way I want to do them.
So if he doesn't like, he just walks out.
No, it's basically, it's an exit. I'll fucking go in.
You know, like, that's so weird.
It's like I'm a rule breaker. You know, we get
oh,
it.
Oh god,
we get it. Phil, you're edgy.
Yeah, you're edgy. Oh yeah, that's a new word I found out. I've always heard the word edgy, but that's like all over the internet these days. Like when someone's trying to be cool, everyone's using the word edgy now.
Yeah.
Like, but I sort of find it ironic because they're making fun of you saying that you're edgy, but they're using a term that's popular on the internet. Like, that doesn't really make any sense.
I don't know. I don't even know what it means. I don't even try to pay attention anymore.
Yeah. Is it warm in here?
It is warm in here.
Holy fuck, man. My heat went out for 2 days. So.
Again.
Yeah, I got my oil tank filled, and about 3 weeks, it just used all of it. So there's something wrong with my furnace. So I had a backup coal stove, and it is fucking smoking us out right now. It is really warm in here.
Yeah, we keep the door closed for obvious reasons. You
yeah,
know?
Sound and all that stuff like that. But my glasses are, like, moist.
I'm a fat guy. I'm always hot. I got that
warm in here too.
I got that under the boob sweat going on.
Yeah, I have it at 60 fucking degrees. I just, whew.
Well, you know, coal stoves, you can only control that so much.
Yeah, I love it. It's really annoying. Like I was telling him earlier, like I blew my nose a little bit earlier and my snot was black. Like I know everyone wants to hear that, but
that's because I haven't like go down here and shovel the ashes and shit. It won't be that bad once you get it.
Yeah.
Get it all going.
Yeah, I got to go to the store and get other stuff for it. Like, it was an emergency. Like, it was, what, 6 fucking degrees out when my heat went out?
Yeah, it was bad. Bad day.
Yeah.
Bad day for heat to go out.
So enough negativity today. You know, all us normal MMA people don't want to.
Enough negativity.
I'm just sorry,
man. Our show is hostile opinions.
I'm sorry, dude. That just fucking pissed me off. Like I said, it wasn't even the Donald Trump shit. I don't give a fuck about that. Whatever. Like, I live my life.
Yeah,
I'm
you're
not
entitled
gonna,
to your opinion.
Yeah, I'm not going to have some fucking, you know... I don't let some guy fucking 100 miles away fucking affect me. I don't care. But it's just when you say that you're a normal person. Like I
act like one.
Yeah, I remember even Mark Wahlberg said, he goes, he came out and he was sick of all these fucking Hollywood people saying we're just like you and stuff like that. He's like, no, you're not.
No.
He's like, I forget what he was on some show or something. He's like, Hollywood people are so out of touch with the normal person. They have no right to say anything.
Oh, yeah, I agree.
It's like, thank you, Mark. Marky Mark and the Funky Factory.
Funky Bunch.
Funky Bunch. You fucking asshole.
Why am I an asshole?
I don't know. You just I'm
the pop culture guy.
I know. You just know everything about music. Like I did, I told everyone I did a trivia round. Or I do a trivia game. This fucker plays. I do an all music round. He knew every single one. Like hardly anyone gets the third round right because it's hard. And I made it really fucking hard. And this fucker gets the whole third
It wasn't. Round. To be fair, it wasn't all me. It was we all contributed a couple.
Oh, okay.
They were one-hit wonders, and we all contributed.
Yeah, the whole round was one-hit wonders, and these fuckers get, like, every single one.
I only got, like, two of them, two out of the ten. I had two that I knew exclusively.
Mm-hmm.
No, I knew ones that other people knew, too, but...
Yeah.
Yeah, whatever. Okay. It doesn't matter.
Yeah, it doesn't. None of this matters.
It don't matter. None of this matters.
So, yeah, moving along after I'm done bitching about everything. What do you got for us today, Jay?
All right, this one's just awesome. So a man in the UK, I don't know why I end up with so many European stories. I don't know, maybe more weird shit happens over there. Anyway, so a man in the UK dies after drinking a bunch of vodka and then wakes up in the morgue, comes back and parties more.
Oh my God, dude.
Which is like really the most British thing ever.
That's I'm surprised it's vodka and it didn't happen in Russia.
Oh no! I'm sorry. It is Russia. I thought it was UK. No, the stories from the newspaper was UK, but it is it's Russia.
I was gonna say that sounds like the most Russian thing I've ever heard in my life.
Yeah. So he woke up in a freezer, stumbled his way out of it towards the shocked staff. Of course, I mean, I bet you they thought a fucking zombie apocalypse was starting.
That's what I would have thought. I'd be like, get the guns.
Yeah. So he couldn't understand where he was. His response was, it's very dark and cold.
Yeah, just a tad. Like, so he actually went back to the party and fucking was like, yo, where's the beer at? I bet she had one hell of a hangover.
Oh, yeah. In the darkness, he felt somebody's completely cold limbs and fear rushed for the door. And that's how he got out of the freezer.
Oh, my God. That is the most hardcore thing I've ever heard in my life, I think.
Yeah, and he went back to the party and he saw his pals were still drinking, but this time they were drinking for his memory, you know, like, hey, here's one for whatever the hell his name
Boris.
Was. Yeah, fuck it, it is Russian.
Yeah, let's we'll just say Boris. Boris.
Here's one for Boris, eh?
And Natasha.
So he comes back, he shows back up at the party, and they all decided to keep drinking in celebration that he was back.
God, that's so crazy.
That's the most Russian thing ever.
I've done some crazy shit in my life, but I've never done something like that. We actually had a friend do that I worked with. His name's John King.
Wait, he got dead and came back?
Yeah, he didn't go back to the party, but he came to work.
Oh, yeah, I remember that.
Yeah, like John King, he fucking pounded a thing of Everclear, like a fifth. He's fucking crazy. He's married and has kids now. I have no idea how.
Like, she calmed him down a little.
Yeah, he was fucking nuts. Well, he dies. They resuscitate him. He wakes up and starts walking out. They're like, where are you going? He's like, I gotta go to work. Like,
that's dedication.
Yeah, they're like, well, you just died. And he's like, I don't care. I gotta go to work.
Like, the day he got an entire can of pepper spray emptied into his face, though, that he didn't come to work that day.
Yeah, he had a party, and the cops were knocking on the door, and he didn't hear him. So I'm not even joking. They got on the roof, like...
Broke in.
Tie, what's that shit called? With the fucking propelling. Ropes. Yeah, propelled through his windows. Sprayed his whole fucking house with mace. Fucked him up bad. They actually got in trouble for that because they're not allowed to do that.
Yeah, he sprayed an entire can of pepper spray in his face and his eyes were swollen for like a week.
Yeah, he was fucking crazy. He used to do so much shit there. Like, we had one guy, Rob. He a habanero and he couldn't drink anything for 20 minutes.
It was one of those do this and you'll get money things.
Yeah. We also, he tased himself. Someone brought a stun gun in. He tased himself in the armpit, I think it was, for $20.
That was John who did that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And then Rob.
Yeah, like, it was powered by a 9-volt battery. You wouldn't think that thing would have much of a kick. Oh, it does.
Yeah, that's fucking crazy, dude. God, some of the fucking people that we had one guy that worked there and he always called off work and said his house burnt down.
Yeah, the other, and his grandmother died.
It was always his grandmother died.
Yeah, that motherfucker had a lot of grandmas.
Yeah, and then we had this guy named Jeff. And
that was the grandma guy.
Oh, was it?
Yeah.
Jeff Campanelli, Shake and Bake.
We shouldn't really be using last names.
Ah, whatever. He doesn't watch this show.
Well, okay,
he had some problems. Let's just say that. And he was on a lot of medication. He always shake. We called him Shake and Bake.
I'll never forget one of our servers who was an absolute just fucking piece of shit. But anyway, this woman, I got some stories about this chick. But anyway, she comes in and she hands Jeff a glass of milk. And he's sitting there, he's shaking. He's like, "What's this for?" He's like, "I wanted a milkshake."
Oh, my God. I think I know who that is.
Yeah, Arlene.
Yeah, one of the only women I know with a happy trail.
Yeah, she had her fucking belly button pierced, and she had to move the hair away for you to see it.
She was cool, and I got along with her. She was just fucking weird. Like, I was at Wegmans one time getting pizza, and she walks up. She's like, "Hey, how's it going?" She just starts picking cheese and pepperoni off my pizza and just starts eating it. I'm like, "Oh, thanks. Help yourself."
She was just a piece of shit.
Yeah, go right ahead. Yeah, Jeff used to crack me up, though. Like, he always used to piss everyone off. Like, he'd get really drunk. He was a hardcore alcoholic.
Oh, yeah.
And he'd, like, fall asleep in a closet or something and come down hours later and not know where he's at. And just, I mean, we'd get pissed at him. He'd be like, he's like, "I'm not the best at what I do, but I'm the only one that does it." And he'd be like, "You guys will miss me when I'm gone."
One day, he used to sneak beers down into the cooler. Our cooler was in the basement in this particular establishment. And he would go down there and sneak a pint of beer. Yeah. And one day, somebody who worked there knew he was doing it, so he dumped out the beer and pissed in the glass. Jeff never said anything about it.
Oh, God. That's like an episode of The Office where this guy on there, I forget what his name is, but he's really fucking weird and like he hardly says anything. They put an onion in place of where his apple was. So he'd take a bite of it. And he doesn't care. He takes a bite of the oven, just sets it down, keeps working.
I never really got into that show.
You have to watch it from the beginning. I watched it from the middle of time. I was like, "What the fuck is this shit?" And then I watched it from the beginning. I'm like, okay, it makes sense now. It's one of those building character things where you have to get to know who the characters are to understand everything.
Yeah, I don't know. Like, the whole fake reality show doesn't really do it for me. Hell, real reality shows are fake enough.
Yeah, I know about it. God, everyone's like, I remember when the Amish Mafia one came out that it was fake. I'm like, no fucking shit.
No way. Or Pawn Stars is accurate. No.
Like, you go, I've known numerous people that have went to there, and when they're not filming, the fucking place is packed. Like, packed.
Yeah.
You can't even get in, but when you watch the show, there's like two people in there. So it's obviously staged. Like, random people just don't come in and they film it. Like, it's obviously staged if it's packed there all the time. And then when they film it, there's like a person in the back. Like,
like the Duck Dynasty thing, you know, that people are coming out that's fake. No kidding.
No fucking shit.
I mean, these people are, that's their personalities. I mean, sure, they're playing somewhat to the camera, but that's their personalities. But like, the producers set them up in situations to do weird shit.
Yeah, I remember the years ago when the Jersey Shore was popular for some fucking reason. They caught that was fake because there was this one bar scene where the camera went off and it looked like Snooki, whatever the fuck that cunt's name is, threw ice at the bartender. But you could see one of the producers in the back with a clipboard and a headset on. She's the one that threw the ice.
Yeah.
And then Snooki goes up and she takes all the liquor and shoves it off the bar. What bar do you know that puts the liquor on the bar?
None.
Like, nobody.
That would be irresponsible.
It's illegal. Like, you're not allowed to. And it's just like, everyone's like, "Oh my God, it's fake." I'm like, no fucking shit. And the thing is like, they're so happy that reality TV is popular because it is so cheap for them to make.
Mm-hmm.
They don't have to build sets. All they have to do is bring in cameras and lights. They don't have to write scripts, really.
They do.
Yeah, they have ideas and stuff like that, but they don't have to pay for fucking all that bullshit.
I feel bad for the editors, though. They have to take like hours and hours and hours of footage and edit it down to something coherent.
Yeah.
But, I mean, even a show that's fairly based in reality, like Deadliest Catch, for example, it's not that it's fake. All the things that you see are going on, but they edit it creatively so something interesting's happening in each episode. Nah. Like, you might be seeing shit that happened at the end of the season, or you might be seeing shit that happened at the beginning of the season. It's all, they put all that shit in there.
Nah.
It's not exactly in a chronological order, but it makes for interesting television.
Yeah, because I noticed that with American Pickers, the one guy, he has a pair of glasses on, and you can buy these glasses that are magnets. They separate, so you can take them off, and then you can, like, right here is where they separate, and there's a magnet.
Right between the eyes.
Yeah, so the one part of the episode, he has them off, and they're together. Well, it flashes to the guy that he's, you know, bartering with or whatever, and it flashes back, and they're separated. And it kept going back and forth, so it's obviously, you know, redone and shot over and over and over and over again, but it's just, it's too much. I never got in a reality show. I sort of got into the Whale Wars a little bit, because I thought that was cool. Because those fuckers are crazy.
Well, my wife prefers reality TV to other things. I mean, not all reality TV. Like, she wouldn't watch, like, Toddlers and Tiaras or some dumb shit like that. But, like, Deadliest Catch or, like, Gold Rush and shit like that. She likes those job ones.
Yeah.
So I ended up watching them with her. So, I mean, I have my, like, my favorite people in some of them. And, you know what? Okay, I'm going off on a rant. Get ready. Sit back. All right. Have you ever watched Bering Sea Gold?
Never even heard of it.
Okay, well, these guys, they run out in these little fucking, they're sheds on pontoons. They're not even boats, but they call them boats. And they're sheds on pontoons, literally. They're all plywood.
On a pontoon.
Yeah, they're all fucking shitty plywood structures all built together. And they go underwater with divers. Mm-hmm. And these divers come and they get these big ass hoses and the suction thing. And they suck it all up, all the pay dirt. And then they run it through a sluice box and collect gold. That's their job. They're gold.
Gold. Right. Sorry.
They're off sea gold miners is what they are. And they're in Alaska. So anyway, there's this one girl up there, this one woman, her name is Emily Rydell, and she has to be the most insufferable cunt I've ever known in my entire life.
Well, like, you got a woman going after gold, of course she's going to
I'd be
cut.
Pulling for her. You don't understand. I'm all about it. Like, if you are a woman, you can go out and do a man's job like that. Yeah, I said it, a man's job. Go out and do it well, and you impress me, I'm all for it. You know, go in there, kick some ass. You know what, if you ever watch... if you ever watch that Gold Rush show, Tony Beats' daughter is a kick-ass.
Nah.
She's a kick-ass miner, and she's a woman. Nah. So, good for her. But anyway, this Emily Rydell chick, she's constantly on the little cutaways, you know, that they do?
Mm-hmm.
Talking about how hard it is to be a woman in this industry, how hard it is to be a woman in this boating industry. And I assume that the producers are feeding her this shit.
Oh, of course they are.
Trying to get her to say it. But
everyone,
you know,
feeds it. You're oppressed.
Nobody is making an issue of her sex except for her.
Exactly. That's what I've been trying to tell everyone.
Okay, you're deafening us all.
Sorry. No, because I get fucking fed up with this bullshit too. No one makes it bad except you.
Yeah, I explained that to Amanda. You know, we were sitting there talking. And she got the wrong impression. She thought that I thought that a woman shouldn't be up there. I'm like, oh, no. You got me wrong. I'm all for it. It's just no one is making an issue of her sex except for her. And she won't dive. She's done it a couple of times, but she has, like, crippling anxiety when she gets on the bottom. So she owns a floating shed, hires
actually,
a crew.
Has she been taken away to the hospital a couple times?
Nothing.
For her anxiety?
Maybe.
Because I thought I saw an episode where she freaked the fuck out and they had to take her to the hospital and give her like an Ativan or something.
That
like
very
that.
Well could be.
Yeah, I think I know what you're talking about. I think I have seen that, actually.
Yeah, I mean, she's just like an insufferable cunt. And like her ex-boyfriend works up there too, and they constantly put these situations together where she has to end up working with him and it's just for drama. And her ex-boyfriend named Zeke, he's an insufferable little douche too, but he seems less annoying than her, so I kind of root for him in most situations. That's her.
Oh god, yeah, she looks miserable.
Well, she just
and that's the thing, like, it's just like no one probably was like giving her shit or anything like that. She's the one saying, oh, it's so hard to be a woman. Of course it fucking is.
I mean, she's got big tits, and she uses her big tits to, like,
probably
she in one episode, they've got her in a bikini and she's out there fixing something in freezing cold water in a bikini, and she's, you know, like, I guarantee
that doesn't make great TV. I don't know what does.
I guarantee. Well, the fact that her face looks like somebody lit it on fire and put it out with
looks
a
like
chain.
Someone beat her with a gold block.
Yeah.
No, I mean, I just,
she's not attractive.
Yeah, I can't stand this shit. Like, of course women bitch about, you know, being a woman, especially today, because they have to work like men do. Because, you know, I've been seeing a lot of women miserable lately. And there was a study on this actually saying how women are getting more depressed in America and men are getting happier. I can see why. Okay. And I can see why. I know people are going to get pissed. I can see why women stayed at home. And the reason for that is they go through a lot more body shit than men do. I am so glad I'm not a man.
You're not a man? I knew
it. A woman.
It.
God damn it.
I knew it.
It's hot in here. I'm getting hot flashes. I'm so glad I'm not a woman, because The whole period thing drives me fucking nuts. God bless you fucking women for bleeding once a month and still going to your job. Okay. But this is why I can see why women are becoming more depressed than men these days. Because, you know, back in the day, you stayed at home, you could deal with this stuff and shit like that. But now that you have to be out in the work thing, like, what's maternity leave these days?
Like 6 weeks, something like that.
So you push a fucking human being out of you, and you go back to work in six weeks?
It depends on the company, really.
I know, but, like, no wonder you're fucking depressed. Like, it's of course it's hard to be a woman, but it's like, you know, you guys wanted this. And, like, I can see why, you know, women stayed at home a lot. Because if I pushed a human being out, I'm never going to the public again.
Yeah, I mean, I agree with you on some respects. Other respects, I don't, because you generally have a pretty negative outlook on women. But I guess I married a fucking catch.
Yeah, and so, it's not even a negative outlook. It's just like I just hear so much bitching, and this is why. Like, it's just you can't push a fucking kid out of your vagina and then go back to work 6 weeks. It shouldn't be like
well,
that.
Well, yeah,
like it just.
I wish that we had more compassion for other human beings in this country. I really do.
I know, we're workaholics. America's always been work.
In a lot of other countries, you know, they have a right to ignore, mm-hmm. so to speak. You know, there's actually laws in certain other countries where when you leave work, like a lot of people are tied to their work emails and shit with smartphones. And a lot of other countries besides the United States, they are expected to ignore and turn off that work email when they leave the building. And that's the way it should be.
Yeah, exactly.
People don't get away. Even on vacations, people still work from their vacations.
I know.
They still do things.
And that's what I'm trying to say. I'm not fucking, for once in my life, I'm not going against women right now. I'm really not. I can see why they're fucking miserable. Because they have to go through their periods and shit, which has to be fucking horrible. Like, and that's why we were talking.
I've gotten cramps before from things, and I felt
I'm
like
miserable.
I was dying.
Yeah, and it's like they do that at work. You push a kid out, and then you go back to work for 6 weeks. No wonder you're pissed off all the fucking time.
Yeah, really.
But it's like if this is what you want, you know, this is what you get. And it's like I was talking to Jay's mom one time. I was like, well, you want an equal right? She's like, I didn't want shit. Your mom cracks me up.
I know, she's funny. Everybody's always like, oh, you wanted equal rights. I didn't want equal rights.
Yeah, she's like, I didn't want it. Fuck you.
So my mother believes strongly in the whole man's work and woman's work thing. Now, you can be mad at her if you want, but that's just the way she thinks. She's like, you know what? I'm not fucking mowing the grass.
Yeah, exactly.
I'm not taking out the trash.
And
I'm not doing it.
Yeah, and that's the
thing. It's like, I'll accept a lower paycheck, but you know what? At home, you're treating me like a fucking princess, too.
Yeah. It's just
that's her opinion, and she's
but
she's
that's considered
to
yeah,
it.
And that's considered sexist. But it's like it works. Like my mom and stepdad, she does all the inside work. She does the laundry and shit, and he mows and does a lot. He builds like ponds and shit outside. He makes the outside look great. And it's like they have this, you know, understandable in between each other that she does the inside work and he does the outside work.
Yeah,
it's
not, fine,
and she's not like bitching. Oh, it's sexist or anything like that. It's just
and like, it, now in my relationship, you know, we try to split things fairly equal as much as possible as time allows. I'm home during the day mostly, and my wife's home during the evening mostly. Mm-hmm. So it's like, you know, certain things got to get done. Dude, I do most of the laundry. I'm not mad about it. I do it because I have time to do it.
Yeah.
And that's just the way it is. And people who try to make an issue out of it are the ones that bother me.
I know. And it's just, it's whatever works. And it's just, you have all these people, you know, poking their nose in and saying all sexism and all this shit. It's just, stay out of people's business. Whatever works. Like, I have a friend, and she has a bunch of kids, and you know what? The husband was like, hey, I would like you home with the kids. So he works, and she stays at home with the kids, and she likes it. But it's like, there's people that think that, you know, it's okay for the mom to be home all the time and stuff like that and take care of it. It doesn't make you a sexist pig. It's just the way it fucking is.
If you can work it out in today's day and age, I think it's great to have a parent home all the time.
I know.
But it's not easy to do now.
And that's why there was a huge study done, and they're calling this generation, not ours, but these kids that are crying over everything, they're calling them the daycare generation.
Yeah.
Because you're putting all these kids, because the mom and dad work all the time, in a daycare, starving for one babysitter's attention. Yeah.
I haven't played a sound yet.
So. I know. For one person's attention. And they don't get it, so they bawl their fucking eyes out, and they say it psychologically affects them when they get older. And they whine and cry about everything. And it's just, it sucks that a parent can't be home all the time. It really does. because babysitters are fucking expensive. I don't even have kids, and I know that.
Well, part of it has to do with the changing tides. You know, back in the day, you used to be able to go out and, even without a college education, go out and get a factory job or something and make enough money to support your family.
Yeah, now you can't do shit.
Those jobs just don't exist anymore. They've been replaced. They've either been outsourced overseas, or a lot of them have just been replaced with automation.
Yeah, my mom told me in the 70s, she worked 6 hours a week and paid for college. 6 hours a week. Mm-hmm. You can't work 40 hours a week and pay for college these days.
No, everything's gotten more expensive, you know, and like I said, the job, everybody always wants some politician or somebody to bring your jobs back to this country. Mm-hmm. I'm sorry to tell you this, folks. It ain't going to happen. It's not even a matter of if you can't. If they would levy a tax to make all these companies bring the quote-unquote jobs back, what's going to end up happening is instead of replacing you with Chinese people that'll work for a quarter an hour, they're going to replace you with robots and automation that will also work. Your job is not being replaced by people. It's being replaced by automation.
And that's the thing.
You're fucked either way. You need. That's why people are stressing so much on STEM jobs.
Yeah. And I see everyone, like, so upset about, you know, elections and, you know, who we're voting for. Government is the fucking problem. That's the problem. Like, I see so many of my friends with small businesses, and constantly the government, local, federal, you know, very local, like your township and everything, constantly, every day fucking them in the ass. Like, just straight up. I saw a shirt at the fair one time that I was going to buy, but they were out of it. It says, "I don't have sex. The government fucks me every day." It's true. They take all they can and everything they can. Like, we were talking about our friend that owns a bar. You have to buy a liquor license here, okay? It was, what, $500, $300 a year or something, or $700 a year? Just like that, they boosted it to, like, $1,400 a year. Just like that.
They had an extra $700 just because they
decided just to. Just laying the fuck around, you know? Not that PLCB, you know, our liquor board, the mafia, comes in and says, "Hey, we heard..." They have no proof. We heard you overserve people. We're finding you $2,000. They do it all the time. They call you
now,
and
we've
say,
never had that happen, but...
For cigarettes, I think we did, didn't we, or something?
Well, the cigarette thing was just plain out a sting operation that they sold, but...
And it's like, and they even call you and tell you, they're like, "Don't even bother fighting it. You owe us $2,000 because we heard you overserve people here." Like,
but just, we never had the overserve thing.
Yeah,
that I'm aware of.
Yeah, I think it was for cigarettes or something. I don't fucking know. It's just, it's constant bullshit. And that is how people are going to make more money. Get the government's fucking hands out of everyone else's pocket, because it's constant bend you over, stick you in the ass. Like, and that's why these companies can't pay people good wages. There's so many restrictions and just everything. Like, it's just ridiculous. Like, there's bars that have to have a tax for playing music. Why?
We have to pay that too. I mean, I work for food, but
I know, like, Jesus Christ, like, you have to. One of the oldest forms that men have created, with drums and fucking, you know, animal fur and skin on them that we used to play, you have to pay money to listen to. There's something wrong there.
Hey, isn't this supposed to be a comedy show?
I don't. I told you I'm on a rant today. I'm on a fucking rant today. I can't help it. Like, I was telling Jay earlier, I didn't have heat for 2 days, so now having heat, I'm become, like, really appreciate lately, because I lay in bed, I'm like, "Oh, my balls feel great right now." So when I hear people bitch, I get really mad, because I just feel like they're ungrateful.
Hey, you know what? Let's start a debate here. Let's bring this back to some comedy.
Oh, okay.
Speaking of balls, shaved or unshaved? Let it all hang out. Tell them. Tell the people.
I'd say slightly shaved.
I keep things trimmed down south. I want to know.
I do too, but it's like to a point where it's like I just don't care anymore sometimes.
Well, nobody's seen your balls most of the time.
Like, I just, like, sometimes, like, shaving your balls suck.
I don't know. I find it refreshing.
Really? I find it fucking annoying.
It sucks when it starts growing back and you get them prickly hair stabbing you in the dick.
It's just really itchy and like, ugh. But I do hate, I do hate having pubes, though, too. Especially when it looks like fucking, you know, the Everglades down there. And like,
looks like Chewbacca took up residence in your pants.
Yeah, and it gets, like, stuck in your, like, "What's that, Chewie?" Fucking Star Wars. Beep, boop, beep. Really, R2.
Like, Chewie would like a sausage.
And you're fucking, like, you have, like, the Everglades down there, and your fucking zipper gets stuck in your pubes. Oh, it's god.
I'm curious how that impression is going to sound on the microphone, because it sounds decent in real life. Knows. But
I don't know.
Might sound like a retarded kid gurgling. Everything, all my impressions sound better in the studio than they do on recordings.
We're getting back on topic, though. We're making fun of retards.
Yeah, I'm just throwing some funny subjects out
there. I was getting serious there. I just can't help it. I've just been on a rant lately.
You know, ladies, I expect you to keep things clean down south. I think the least I can do is do the same.
See, I don't mind that. Like, when Hammer was on a show, we were talking about it. I don't, like, I just...
Nah, I like it. I like it fucking bald, man, you know?
See, I really don't care. Like, I just don't care. Like,
you know what I like? When a girl has that slap sound when you're going at it and, yeah!
I do, too, but it's usually across their face. Just joking. Huh. Am I? But
when both parties are removed of the hair, you get that nice little slap sound.
Yeah, I do like that. But, like, I don't know. When a woman has a bush, it's like your instincts kicked in. Like, you go caveman. like the SpongeBob caveman meme. Like, you see that, and you're like, and then, like, it makes you go, bah, wah, and you're just like, you're like, I don't know. I don't have a machete, but I'm going to eat that pussy.
Like, no, I don't like picking hairs out of my tongue.
I don't like carbon burn on my tongue either, but still, like, I don't know. I just get in, like, instinct mode. Like, the music starts playing, like, ooh, wah, 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 wah. Like, you know, Tarzan's flinging in the background. He's the one that comes in through the window, hands me the condom.
What about shaving the rest? Do you groom?
No, because I really don't grow body hair. Like, I don't.
You are a 12-year-old.
I know, dude. Like, I was playing WoW last night, and these people were asking me what I look like, and I'm like, I look like Sheldon Cooper.
You kind of do.
That's actually my nickname out here when I first moved. I don't think I do, really. I don't care, whatever.
He does.
Yeah, whatever. But
for those of you who don't watch on YouTube, go to YouTube.
But I'm this pale sour cream kid. Like, and I have a little bit of chest hair right here. That's it.
Dude, I knew a guy who had a perfect Batman symbol in his chest hair. It just grew that way.
Dude, that would be awesome.
He was a redhead, too.
So. I'd probably get arrested because I'd just walk around naked all the time. I just would. I wouldn't give a fuck. Or, like, yeah, whatever. That's fucking awesome. Yeah, but I actually seen that. There was things where these Cubans, you know how Cubans are. Yeah. They sell drugs. No, I'm joking.
Jesus Christ. Okay, Donald.
Yeah, I know. Sorry. Sorry, the wall didn't go up yet. But, and, like, I guess hair art is a thing now where they do, like, Batman symbols in the back of people, or in the back of, you know, people when they have hairy, you know,
if I was physically fit, I would remove the hair.
Yeah.
I think the chiseled hard body.
Yeah.
If you got that going on, you can pull off the hairless look. If you're fat and chubby, exactly. Then you just look like... You just look like a man baby.
I know. Yeah, and that's the thing. If you're ripped, I think shaving's good. But if you're not, don't fucking manscape.
Yeah, you look like a man baby.
Yeah, don't manscape if you're not good looking.
Unless unless you're talking down south and you like the slappy noises. I like the slappy noises.
Yeah, I do too.
Yeah, slappy noises are nice.
I don't really care. Like, I don't know. Like, I remember this one girl. I took off her pants and she was wearing like these little ducky underwear and I was like, oh, this girl's, you know, fucking
like rubber ducks.
Yeah, like little rubber ducky underwear and stuff. And I took on. There was just this bush there and I was like, it wasn't. And then it handed me a crossbow laser and shot Kylo Ren from miles away. Sorry, I'm not getting on a Star Wars rant today. I still haven't seen the fucking movie yet. Have you?
Rogue One. I don't care to see it.
Nah. I haven't seen it yet. I don't fucking know.
I don't care. I'm not interested. I don't care about Star Wars. I watch the main movies just because it's a pop culture thing and I don't want to be left out in the water cooler. But that's about it.
Yeah, I don't know. And, like, it's just... I knew Disney was going to do this, but it's like they're just oversaturating it.
Yeah, well, you know, they're trying to sell it to a new generation of children. And it's all about money.
And that's the thing. Like, I was talking to a friend one time
money.
Like that.
Yeah. Pay us money. Patreon.
Pay us money, bitches. But I was talking to a friend about that. And he's like, I don't understand advertising. I was like, what do you understand about it? He's like, well, you guys, he's from Canada. He's like, you guys down in the south and there, you know, you have the Super Bowl and everything's commercials. And he's like, I don't sit there and watch a TV commercial. And was like, you know what? I'm going to go out and buy some Doritos. I'm like, yeah, you don't. It's for kids. Like, what do you think those kids are going to do? Mommy, I want some Doritos. And the mom's going to be like, will this kid shut the fuck up?
And DVRs with commercials, yeah. Kid, brother.
And you know how that mom or that dad shuts that kid the fuck up? She buys him Doritos.
DVR with commercial skips is the greatest thing ever.
Yeah, what's that one comedian you like? Steve Kelly or whatever his name is.
Which one? I like lots
of comedians. He always smoked cigarettes.
Oh, are you talking about...
Oh, Kelly. Kelly something.
Not Kelly.
No, it wasn't...
Are you talking about Bill Hicks?
Yeah, Bill Hicks.
Bill Hicks is my favorite of all time.
Yeah, I don't know
that
why...
That Dennis Leary stole his entire act from.
I don't think... Yeah, I don't know where Kelly came from, but like you saying about how... You show me the one skit where he's like, no, seriously, if you're in advertising, go fucking die.
Yeah.
And like everyone's laughing and he's like not. And he's like, no, seriously, go fucking kill yourself.
Like, it's the only way you can save your fucking soul. Go kill yourself.
Yeah. Like,
if you guys haven't heard of Bill Hicks, go look for some YouTube videos. He was cut short from life very
Yeah, he
soon.
Smoked like a fucking fiend.
He quit before he died. But, well, it supports your theory. You stop doing what you're doing, you're done.
Yeah.
Anyway,
I've seen it so many times.
Anyway, Bill Hicks is a fucking genius. You have to look up his comedy. The other one I love, the more than life itself, mm-hmm. who was also taken way too early, was Mitch Hedberg. He was a great comedian who worked entirely in one-liners. And I don't know about you, but filling a two-hour set with nothing but one-liners would be fucking tough.
Yeah, that's why Dice Clay, or whatever the fuck his name was, popular. His whole fucking skit was basically one-liners.
Yeah, I mean, he'd throw in those dirty nursery rhymes and shit. But like most comedians will fill up their time using stories, funny stories with a punchline. But I mean, like Mitch Hedberg, it was all one-liners. Like one of his jokes I love is, I like an escalator because an escalator can never break. It can only become stairs. You'll see a sign
I've always heard that quote. I didn't know he was the one that did that.
You'll find a sign on the escalator. Escalator temporarily stairs. Sorry for the convenience.
I've always heard that. I didn't know that was the person.
Yeah. Yeah, Mitch Hedberg. Go look him up. He's hilarious. There's an uncut version of his Comedy Central skit or special. It's hilarious.
What did he die from? Was it alcohol? Probably
related to drugs.
Yeah,
he had a big,
and that's the thing. Like comedians,
stage fright problem.
Comedians are fucking depressed people, and that's why they have to, you know, make people laugh all the time. Like Hicks, he chain smoked all the time because he was so fucking depressed all the time.
I don't know if it was depression.
It probably was.
in Bill Hicks' case, it probably was because Bill Hicks was a social commentator mm-hmm. in the skin of a comedian.
Yeah,
like he was. John Stewart before John Stewart was John Stewart. He was Lewis Black before Lewis Black.
I didn't watch a lot of this Hicks guy, but that thing I can tell that he has a pure hatred.
Oh yeah.
When he talks about it, he's depressed. That's like Robin
Williams.
Well,
he's angry.
Yeah, that's like Robin Williams. Like people were shocked. I'm like, you can tell by Robin Williams how quick and, you know, witty he is, and how he's like, that there's something going on up there. You know what I mean?
Well, apparently they changed his medication on him. And you know how they always say suicidal thoughts are a side effect of this medication.
Yeah.
Well, that's what happened. He told his wife, according to her anyway, he mm-hmm. told his wife at the time, like, I wish I could reboot my brain. Something's wrong. Yeah. I don't feel right. Something's not right. And then, you know, she comes home one day and he's swinging from a belt off of the door. You know,
yeah, and that's why like medication's like no joke. Like, you know, they just give that shit to you like it's nothing, but it's seriously no joke. Like it does that shit all the time. Like you read stories about a woman that puts all her kids in a van, drives in a lake and drowns them all, finds out she was on medication. And then like that's just scary to me where he's like, yo, something's wrong. Like I he's a smart guy. You know what I mean? So he knew, he's like, you know, something's fucking wrong. And it was probably the medication. That shit does crazy shit to you. Yeah. I don't know. And it just and a lot of comedians I see are just, you know, very smart, but they're very depressed at the same time because they're very smart. And they just, I don't know, like.
They always say there's a fine line between genius and insanity.
Yeah, it's like, what's his name? Not Jim Jeffries. Who's the fucking roast master? It's always on the roast shows.
Oh, I don't fucking know.
The big Jew nose guy. Or whatever.
Oh, my God.
Wait, he makes fun of himself about it. Dude, he's the one that made fun of the Colorado Aurora shooting, like, right after it happened. So I can say Big Nose fucking freak.
But well, of all people, you can say something about somebody having a big nose.
Hey, mine doesn't hook.
No, it's just fucking bulbous.
I know, it just has this ball to it, and that's about it.
Jeff Ross,
that's it. Yeah, I can't remember. Yeah, but someone, he was just ripping at this roast. Someone was giving him shit, and he's like, comedy comes from pain. He's like, people, just shut up. People, pain, you know, this. That's where comedy comes from, pain and suffering and stuff like that.
So a guy cut his thumb off in a beef jerky plant. Trying to keep the mood light here. Dude cut his thumb off at a beef jerky plant. He was fired after he called 911 to report it. Yeah, the owner of a now-closed beef jerky maker is being sued by the federal government for firing an employee who tried to call 911 to help a coworker with a severed thumb.
See, this isn't the story that you cover when you're trying to lighten the mood. Because we were just talking about corporations being greedy and shit like that. But go on, go on.
So the Lone Star Western Beef Plant in Fairmont... So if you happen to have any products from them, you might be eating thumb.
Wait, what's it called again?
Now I got to look for it again, you son of a bitch. Lone Star Western Beef Plant.
Oh, okay. Never heard of it.
So, yeah.
Sounds like it's from Texas.
Quite possibly. Either way, so dude cut his thumb off. It ended up in the beef jerky, I guess. And they contacted OSHA, contacted 911, and said, "Hey, dude lost his thumb. What are we gonna do here?" And the coworker got fired for calling 911.
So someone is eating thumb jerky.
Someone's eating thumb jerky.
Because you know that if this company won't let this fucker call 911, you know they don't give a fuck if that thumb's in there.
Nah,
that's fucking disgusting.
I thumb my nose at this situation.
No, that's fucking disgusting, though. That shit probably happens a lot, though. Like, that one guy that found a rat in his monster. That was fucking disgusting. I seen that a while ago.
I remember the Capri Sun fungus. Did you see that one?
Oh, yeah, in the bottom of the Capri Sun.
Yeah. That's manufacturing defects happen. It had a fucking pinhole in it. That's why they have clear backs now, so you can see.
Yeah, and that's why I drink Kool-Aid Jammers. I do. I don't give a fuck. I'm 32 years old, and I still eat Lunchables, too. Like, that is my snack when I play WoW, is Kool-Aid Jammers and Lunchables.
He's single, ladies.
Yeah.
Single.
Yeah.
Who wants to get with... I know that I'm off the market, but who wants to get with this?
I couldn't tell you why I'm single. What woman doesn't like Kool-Aid Jammers and Lunchables?
Ones who are above the age of 12.
Oh, shit. That's what I'm doing wrong.
Now I know why you live here.
Yeah, for you people who don't know, we have a child molester that lives in
that. They know if they've watched any episode of the show.
In my town, and it's not me. Surprise, it's not me. He lives like a couple houses that way.
I actually let him babysit my kids. So.
Yeah, I am. Like, kids love me, actually. Like,
yeah, because he feeds them a bunch of junk food and lets them throw mud clots at the church I live next to. Although I got to give you credit, you stopped them and cleaned it up. So I
know, dude.
That.
Like, I don't know. Just kids love me for some fucking reason. I don't know.
It's because you're a big kid.
I know. I think that's why. Like, I had my brother has this girlfriend, and they invited me over for Christmas, and she has an awesome family, and it was awesome, and she has this little girl, and she's, like, the cutest fucking thing ever, and just flew right to me. We started playing, like, Kinetic Santa. Shit's fucking crazy.
That shit's fun.
I know. And she's like, I'm sick of playing this. Let's play, you know, Nurse, Are You Hurt? And she grabs a scotch tape and just starts putting tape all over my face. My whole face is covered, and she's like, oh, better, baby.
That's funny.
Like, I'm just like, I just don't know what it is with kids.
You know what game's bitching, and I'm so glad we got our kids this for Christmas?
What's that?
Jenga.
I love Jenga. Someone made life-size Jenga.
Somebody took a bunch of 2x4s. I saw it just today.
Yeah.
Somebody took a bunch of 2x4s and made a Jenga set out of it, and this kid's playing, and it falls over, falls right into the kid's face. It's like, that's a good way to break your child's nose.
Yeah, people are doing that with, like, beer pong. They're buying those huge fucking Rubbermaid containers, and they're using soccer balls. And there's no, like, regular beer pong anymore. They're putting they're getting Roombas and putting the beer pong things on it so that it's moving.
Moving target. Yeah. That's not fair to drunk people.
I know. And it's like, guys, you're in college, man. You have to think in school enough. That's your relaxing time. Just play regular beer pong, man.
You know what I hate is Higher or Lower. That's a game just designed to fuck you up.
Did you ever play Three Man?
No, what's that?
It's a dice game, and it's the first time I've ever seen someone puke on the ceiling. I'm not joking.
How does one puke on a ceiling?
You drink so much so quick, you just fucking lose it.
Projectile.
Yeah, it's my friend John, and we all live together, and he's like, I'm going to be sick. Just fucking hit the ceiling. I'm not even joking. And I remember it was red. I don't know what he had that was red. I think it was like a Mountain Dew or something. But
Code Red Mountain Dew.
Yeah, and it was red, and it was all over the ceiling. It was just horrible. It's a really fast dice game. And it's like, if you roll a 1 and a 2, you become the 3 man. So every time someone rolls a 3, you drink.
Oh.
It's just fucking, it's insane. It's probably the craziest drinking game. That's probably
higher or lower is my kind of drinking game because it fucks you up quickly and it's simple.
Yeah, it is.
You simply have a card. They lay it down. Is the next one going to be higher or lower than this? You guess. If you're wrong, you drink.
Yeah.
I like and you're game. Wrong a lot.
Yeah, when you start playing Kings or whatever like that, where there's all those rules and shit.
Fuck rules.
Yeah, fuck rules, man.
You know what? A favorite drinking game I saw this year, and we're gonna have to try it next year around Christmas time televise it because this is fucking hilarious.
Oh god!
You take a Santa hat and you put it on the corner of the TV.
Oh yeah.
And every time somebody wears the hat, you have to drink.
Yeah, I've seen that because like they'll be in the side of the screen, and the Santa hat will be on the corner of the TV, and it looks like they're wearing it. And you have to drink.
So we're gonna do that one of these days. Sometime in the near future too, we are also gonna do a Mario Kart challenge here.
Yeah.
Casey and I are gonna play Mario Kart. I
fucking love Mario Kart, man.
Probably tell some stories, talk about some dumb shit, swear at each other a lot, maybe not be friends anymore afterwards. Especially if the blue turtle shell comes out.
Oh god, man, don't get me started.
So with Nintendo's new console release, we should do that.
I know, and that's the thing. Like me and Jay, when we're on our off time and stuff like that, like we're very busy people. You know, I basically work 7 days a week with the podcast and everything, and work, and I do that Quizzo trivia and stuff.
I masturbate a lot.
Yeah, he masturbates. No, he has he fucking jackass. I do too, but he has kids, a family, he works too, and it's just like there's so much shit we want to do for this channel, and it's just to find time, man. Like today, we were like, we're not really pressed for time, but we are today because just recently, his kid's school was like, hey, there's an ice storm coming. They're getting out early. And Jay's like, dude, we got to like get going with the show, man. There's like a huge ice storm coming. I'm like, where's there? I didn't even hear about it. I didn't hear anything about it until Jay texted me and said that there's a huge ice storm coming. I'm like, ice storm? Is that a comic book character?
if not, we need to trademark that shit.
Yeah, I know. I was like, who's this Ice Storm? Or it sounds like an old Metallica album. Ice Storm, yeah!
Trapped under ice!
Yeah, that's probably why I'm thinking of it.
Speaking of that, if you guys want to have a laugh, speaking of people who say yeah a lot, Rob Zombie beats the shit out of James Hetfield.
Yeah.
Look up on YouTube, Rob Zombie says yeah. It's like every instance of yeah on Astro Creep 2000 in part two is every instance of yeah on Les Exorcisto, Devil Music Volume 1. And like I think Les Exorcisto, which is my favorite White Zombie album, has 119 yeahs.
I know he was playing it the other day, and it's just...
fucking hilarious.
Whoever did that had a lot of time, because like I edit these videos, and I know editing takes a long time. So he listened through every single song, recorded every yeah, put them all together... Like, and then they made a video about it.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
It's every yeah, and it's
fucking hilarious. Rob Zombie has a yeah problem.
Yeah, I know he does.
You know what? Speaking of that, White Zombie was awesome, but Rob Zombie,
yeah, I don't know. I liked them both. Like,
Jay
I didn't
Younger
really
was a much better guitar player than anybody's had since.
I just remember White Zombie wanted to fuck what's her name,
Sean Yelsel.
Oh god,
she's a.
Sex sells, man, and they know
she,
it.
She didn't. She's a good bass player too.
I know, and that's the thing. You're just like, that's like Kitty, man. When I was young, when I was like 15, 13, 14.
They're terrible, but
I know, but you can't put hot chicks in front of a 13-year-old kid and play instruments.
If you want to listen to a band with hot chicks that's actually good, you could try the Donnas. Just saying.
I know, but dude, when good you're 13 band. Years old. You don't put a bunch of Canadian hot women in front of a kid.
They're Canadian.
Yes.
That explains a lot.
It does.
They're not.
It explains a lot.
Canadian women are very nice. I meant that their personalities are pleasant.
I bet. I know.
You can come over to my house and fuck my sister.
God, we don't play sound effects anymore. Play a couple more just to...
Okay, there's a fart. Here's an awkward cricket. Vomiting. Sensor beeps.
We should play that every fucking second.
Every.
You're second. Right. I do use fuck like a verb. I can't help it.
You use it like a period or a comma.
I don't know. Like I said, man, I just.
You keep using the word. I don't think it means what you're thinking.
I'm very thankful lately because I've been through some shit lately, so it's just like I've been on a rant. I can't help it.
I promise pretty soon that we're going to get. Mark Hammer back on here again pretty soon.
Yeah, did anyone like Mark? I know no one really talks to us.
Yeah, fuckers don't ever say anything.
We have a
quietest audience on the face of the planet.
What was his screen name? I think it was PC Pokey or something like that.
I don't know.
He's been commenting on videos. Thank you. If you're watching this, thanks, man. Because that's the whole reason me and Jay started this, is just to have conversations with people. And you've been awesome. Like, you've been commenting and stuff like that. Thank you.
I started this just to stroke my own ego and whatnot.
Oh, okay, great. The truth comes out. Are you like Meryl Streep? We're like you normal people. She's wearing like this 15-pound diamond necklace.
We are like you normal people because we have jobs and life.
I just love it, too, because she started going like that. She started tearing up. I'm like, oh, here we go.
Oh, my. Oh, my.
I'm like, here Meryl Streep, we go.
You always knew she was mad in the movies because she'd take her earrings and shit off. Meryl Streep's going to kick your ass.
I know, it's like, uh-oh. And that's the thing. It's like, she thinks that's powerful or something. It's like, oh, I have to go from woman to kick ass. There's only one good scene where a person takes their earrings off, and that is in True Blood. And if you haven't seen it, there's a part where this guy, he's a gay cook, and these rednecks come in.
Oh, yeah, that's a great
movie. Oh, it's a great scene. And I didn't know it was from True Blood for a while. But he comes in, and these rednecks find out that the cook's gay. And they tell the waitress, they're like, I didn't want no AIDS burger. So this gay guy, he's like, what? He takes his earrings off, and he goes out there, just rips into these people. It's the greatest fucking scene I've ever seen in my life.
Extra AIDS.
Yeah. He's like, here's your booger, extra AIDS. He just beats the fuck out of these rednecks. It is awesome. Check it out.
Mostly verbally.
Yeah, I know. And that's the thing. He just verbally rips into them, and then they... You know, be rednecks. Not all rednecks are bad, just a lot of them. Just joking. I love rednecks. Like the coal stove thing that I said, like, I had so many people help me out. Like, I know a lot of people make fun of rednecks and stuff like that. I've never had so much help in my life when my heat went out. Like, no one I know probably watches this show. Actually, Tigger does, I think.
We know a lot of people who watch this
Tigger,
show.
Tigger's a truck driver, and he listens to our show or whatever. So, Tigger, if you're listening... Thank you. You saved my fucking life. God, still got AIDS, I guess. Yeah, my heat went out at 10 at night, and he came over at like 11, and he was helping me. We were trying to get that fucking cool stove started, so thanks, Tig. I love you long time. And his nickname is Tigger, because I guess when he was younger, he used to jump on the bed a lot. So, Tigger, if you're listening, love you long time. Thank you for all the help. Thanks to, you know, Terry and Ron for helping me. Because I almost froze to fucking death. Because it was fucking cold.
Yeah. I got wood, which is more of a pain in the ass.
Oh, really? I can tell.
Yeah, yeah.
And those pants, I can tell.
My sexy jeans.
Oh, man. Ice storm's coming.
Everybody, I thank you for tuning in this week, as always. If you like us, please hit that subscribe button. Share it with your friends. If you know anybody who thinks a bunch of idiots getting on here ranting about dumb shit is entertaining as much as you do, please feel free to share it with anybody you know who might like it. We got some new and exciting shit in the future, so if you haven't subscribed, you really want to.
Yes. I was really randy today. I can't help it.
You were really randy?
Fuck everyone.
Randy?
Randy!
If you want to support the show, we'd really appreciate it. Even a dollar is a huge help. Go to patreon.com/openlyhostileopinions. You can tweet us if you want to have us answer any questions at Hostile Opinions.
Yeah, please. Like I said, like last episode, like, please just, you know, we'll talk about anything.
Yep. Follow us on Facebook. Follow us on Twitter. Follow us on Google+. We're out there on every social platform. We're out there with our cocks out. Whatever you want.
Yeah, dude, I'll answer shit on Twitter. I don't give a fuck. Whatever. We were just talking about Jay's boner.
Hey, why not?
Like, I'll talk about anything. Whatever.
If you have a beer recommendation, we love those because we're running out of creative ideas. So
yeah, I know. We're just getting beer that we like. Like KP, he's the one that did the Christmas one,
yeah,
I think.
Thank you, KP Smith, for the beer
suggestions.
Yeah, so
we'll even take beer suggestions. We don't care. Yeah, and, like, right. We did the Fat Tire last week or something, and he talked to KP, and he's like, yeah, it sucks.
Yeah, Flat Tire sucks.
Yeah, it does.
All right, man.
Thank you, everyone. Have a good night.
This has been the Openly Hostile Opinions podcast. We are available on YouTube, Google Play, iTunes, and your favorite podcast app. Be sure to like, subscribe, rate, and comment. If you want to help make all this possible, become a patron at patreon.com/openlyhostileopinions.
Good morning!
Morning!
Good morning!
Oh, and in case I don't see you, good afternoon, good evening, and good night.